responses, if I'm not mistaken, either four or five responses that I dealt with directly. I found them online posting through other people or whatever. I responded to them, talked to them, you know, told them what to do, how to get the help that they need, where to go to, how to seek it, all that stuff. You know, there are vets out there that need fucking help. And I'm going to say this real quick. Anybody that's listening, if you know somebody or if you yourself need help, reach out to anybody that you know that's a vet. They will get you the resources that you need. They will help you in any way they can. If they can't, they will put you in contact with somebody else that can. Do not let yourself get drowned by, you know, stress and you know, all that negative bullshit. Look at the positive things. No matter how fucked up shit is, look at the positive fucking things in your life and seek the help that you need. Because only you can fix you. We can help you fix you, but you have to want it.
That's right. That's right. And at some point in time, you're going to have to take it over yourself, which, you know, that's where your advocates can come into play and show you how to deal with them. And you can go in there and tell them, say, look, you're not going to pump me up with 15 different medications. This is what works, and this is what I'm going to be on. And if you're not going to give it to me, if you have track error, if you've been on documentation, everything, so if you've been on a certain pain regimen or any kind of medication regimen, if it's on documentation, you slap it in front of their face. You know, this is what the military had me on. This is what we tried. This is what works. Give it to me. If they don't, go see a civilian doctor. Plain and simple. But as far as like your specialty things when it comes to, you know, prosthetics, wheelchairs, you know, CPAP machines and everything else, you know, you need to get in there and get those referrals done so they can start processing that stuff. And everybody bitches and complains about the time. My PCP has 1,100 patients. You know, sometimes it takes a little bit of time. I made my yearly checkup appointment at the end of December. They didn't have an opening until the 6th of February. So, hey, cool. Gotcha.
I'm lucky. I don't have to.
Amen, Chris.
I mean, for me, mine is... Shit, what is it? She's got 900 people that she's working with herself because she covers, well, my VA facility, we cover my county, the county east of me, west of me, and then one county across the river in South Shore, Kentucky, and that area. So a lot of people, you know, from Kentucky and two other counties here in Ohio come to my facility, and they only have three doctors for all these vets. And for me, I mean, I got lucky. Somebody canceled out. I got slipped into their appointment, you know, Thursday. I got to go back because my pain management regimen that my doctor and myself have established is not working. It worked at first and my body's adjusted. Now I have to go higher. I don't like it, but I have to find what's going to work for me to keep me from being in consistent pain. Because I can tell you right now, the last 2 days, I've been in nothing but consistent fucking pain, and it sucks.
I can understand your pain, brother. Unfortunately, I can, though. So, all right, y'all. It's in the morning. We got a good little crowd. Let's go to a quick little song break real quick. Let's do something that I bet most of y'all probably haven't heard in a long time. Gotta love this guy.
Everybody's looking for some.
It's the devil himself that all our parents made us take the CDs back because they thought he was fucking nuts just because of the way he looked.
Oh, man.
I was saying that. I was like, yeah, I got to have that.
Back in 2001, my buddy, his mom and dad went and got him tickets for Ozfest, and they bought 6 tickets. Well, one of our other friends was supposed to go. He bailed, and so he gave me the ticket, and his mom and dad took us up and dropped us off. They were planning on going to some kind of business meeting, like family meeting thing that they had at his dad's corporate office up in Columbus. So it worked out perfect. So we get to the show. We sat through, some shitty-ass bands, some really good bands like Kitty. Oh, my God, they were fucking awesome. Who the fuck was that? Crazy Town. Crazy Town got on stage and got booed off. They didn't even get through one fucking song, which was fucking awesome. But I got to actually see him live, and he was in his 30-foot dress. Dude, they fucking jacked his ass up in the stage, and he had that fucking dress on. It was fucking crazy.
I think I was at that same show.
Oh, shit.
I was just getting ready to say, where the hell is Jay at?
I was at a couple of Ozfest. Was it the one that with Pantera or no?
It was in 2001.
Okay. I went to a couple of them.
See, Linkin Park was there, Disturbed, Godsmack, Crazy Town, which they fucking suck, Kitty, Ozzy.
Was Korn there? Or was that... I might be thinking of a different one. But I know Marilyn Manson played a couple of Ozfest.
Korn was there and Slipknot was there. And Slipknot... The only reason why Slipknot was there is because one of the fucking drummers climbed up on top of a fucking 20-foot speaker and jumped off head first onto the drum. Knocked himself out.
Oh. Ow. Shit.
Yeah.
Those anytime I went to Ozfest, I pretty much was drinking, so, and I really hate it because I saw Pantera and I don't remember a lot of it.
Were you one of those girls walking around with her fucking boobies hanging out, like shaking them and flashing them at everybody?
No, she's one of the girls that walks around with a bar inside of her purse.
I was the one crowd surfing. And getting trying to get
surfing my ass.
See, at the amphitheater in Columbus, they have, you know, obviously they have the main seats that, you know, face up to the stage, but then they have what they call the grass. And the grassy area gets fucked up every time. Why? When a major event like that comes in during, like, especially like Ozfest, the year that I was there, they were literally, guys were digging their hands into the dirt, pulling up, like they were pouring water all over the hillside to get the whole thing slippery and wet. And they were sliding down it, and they made a mud pit. Well, then they would like just ground their hand into the fucking ground, pull out a handful of mud, and just sling it at everybody in the seats, obviously, because they were pissed off at, you know, they had cheap seats. They got pissed off. Well, fuck you, you know, bum.
All right.
Yeah,
so
now instead of Ozfest, they have the Carolina Rebellion. It's pretty freaking awesome.
So, here we go again with the ladies dressing up in vaginas. Again.
Nope.
Maybe we should start teaching our daughters how to get their way through life with hard work and not sex in their bodies. Maybe we should teach them that their minds and skills are worth something. Maybe we should teach them how to carry themselves with pride in class. Let's change the new nasty trend that is destroying womanhood. Liberal women say it the right. They are nasty women, totally disgusting, but do not represent all women, thank God. So please share your best. It's just more women dressing up in these damn vagina costumes. I think it's stupid. It's really
stupid
dumb.
As shit. Yes.
It's really
Thank
dumb.
You.
And they don't even look like real vaginas anyway. It looks like a hot dog bun with a hot dog in it. They're split in half.
That thing you were talking about earlier with USAA, Ron just actually shared it 26 minutes ago. It says USAA is offering a no interest payroll advance loans to military members during shutdown. So
that's what's up. Yeah, I thought I was looking that shit up yesterday when we seen that shit, because I was wondering if it was going to protect retirees, but apparently retirees are on a different branch of payment, so you know the retirees don't get affected. But yeah, I wouldn't be pissed off if they took like a quarter of our check, of every retiree's check, to put towards that, to active duty. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I wouldn't see nothing wrong with that. Not at all. Because, I mean, some of us make pretty good.
See,
I didn't see that at the beginning of the game. That fucking sucks. One out of three teams.
That's the thing. A lot of the national broadcast channels, they're not airing that shit. They're leaving it cut out of the airtime so that people don't see it and get pissed off by it. It's a deal that they worked out between them and the NFL.
Well, as much as I hate to say it, I guess I'm going to pull fucking New England on this one. God damn it.